My name is Kirsten, and I'm here to help you with your All-State music this year for Kentucky 2020. The Adagio etude is actually taken from the Rose 32 studies. It is an excerpt from number 23. The things that we're looking for in these slow studies are sound. You must always play with your best sound, nice, beautiful sound. Phrasing, make the notes always lead from a place to a point. I'll show you how we can do that in a minute. And rhythm. Rhythm is extremely important. I recommend practicing this all the time with the metronome until you're about ready to have your audition. The marking that you'll notice at the beginning are d'antemante. If you look that up, that means fiery and passionately. So we must play this with a lot of expression. So one way we can have some expression and direction to the notes is to subdivide. And we can think of each one of the little subdivisions in that first note, the dotted quarter note G, leading somewhere. So initially I would practice a slower tempo. Don't obviously practice up to tempo. So this is 85, and this is for eighth note. So each one of those eighth note subdivisions is leading. We're going all the way to the E flat, and then we back away a little. Going on in measure 11, you'll notice there's a little bit of a challenging interval from B flat to E flat. So I recommend using a half hole. So B flat is like this, and then slide the finger over to get the half hole, and you'll be surprised how easily that the E flat will come out. The next area that's a little bit difficult are the 32nd notes. So practice the 32nd notes slowly. And then you can phrase them. And then notice which interval is difficult. Are you having difficulty with making it a clean sound without getting a note in between? I find that the G to the B flat is a little tricky. So isolate that area. When you're practicing, don't start from the beginning and go to the end and hope it'll all fall together. You have to look for the difficult areas, the ones that are challenging. Some of us have challenges at the same places, others of us have other challenges. So start perhaps with the interval, the B flat to the E flat. Every day when you pull this out to work at it, don't start at the beginning. And then you can work on the 32nd notes. The breathing is also an issue. I would put your breath marks in. There are different places where you can breathe in this, but make sure you're always breathing at the end of a phrase and you're finishing your phrase. So I take a breath after the D natural in measure 12. Make sure you finish your phrase so we're not hearing. There's a comma, a little apostrophe, a breath mark before the GA grace notes. That doesn't mean you need to take a breath there. It only indicates that you must make a little space. So you really shouldn't even need a breath by that time. Again, there's another nice place you can use that half hole. So B natural to D. And then going on, measure 15. We have to make sure we're subdividing just exactly right so we get from the F to the E-flat on time. So while you're playing the eighth note F, make sure you're subdividing into four parts. So after you articulate it a few times, and then you can just think the subdivisions. And then when you play your low A, there's a dot over it, but it doesn't mean to chop it off. It just means to make a little space. And again, the E-flat, that's a nice place to use that half hole too. A couple other things we can talk about. The tied notes, again, subdividing in measure 16, the tendency will be to get off that C too soon. So I recommend subdividing this time, articulate the eighth notes. So diminuendo down to piano at that point. Also, the B flat, you'll notice it's going to want to be a little sharp. You can use what we call cover fingering, so your B flat is like this. I usually use the third finger, and the C key. If it's really sharp on your clarinet, you can put your whole right hand down. Also, take a look at measure 20. It's going to be very problematic for intonation at 20. So you're playing B flat. I would use those cover fingerings. That's going to be sharp. Your long B natural, that's going to want to be flat. So you might even need to keep your whole right hand down there. And then at the end, you can grade your diminuendo at the very end. We can use those subdivisions again to feed the phrase. This is two measures before the end. So each one of those little eighth notes that I'm articulating, each one just gets a little bit softer so you can finish the phrase. So you're obviously not going to articulate those when you play this, but it's an excellent way to practice grading your diminuendo. Another thing I recommend doing, before you make your tape or auditioning in person, I think it's a tape this year. But before you make your video of recording, make sure you have the beginning of this very solid. So I would practice the beginning, just the beginning first measure, and then probably go all the way to the E flat. And so you get a good start, you're not stumbling along trying to get the first measure out. And also practice that last phrase at the end. You're gonna be a little tired by the time you get to the end, and make sure you have enough air, make sure you have enough stamina to get through to the very end. All right. Good luck. Let me know if you have any questions. I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you.